Eurobasket 2019, and it's the second semifinal between Spain and Serbia. Of course, the winner is going to advance to tomorrow's title game and play France, who made it to the final for the fourth consecutive women's Eurobasket after beating a very brave Great Britain team. You see Ana Davidović there, the leader of this Serbia team. Well, she's got the wrapping on her left hand, and that is because of a broken bone. However, it's going to take more than a broken bone to keep her out of a game like this. She's going to give everything. So today already we've seen Belgium win impressively over Hungary and Russia fall to Sweden. So the Belgians and Swedes advance to the FIBA Women's Olympic qualifying tournaments next year. France saw off a really pretty Great Britain team, 63-56, to advance to the finals. So Great Britain will face the loser of this next game between Serbia and Spain in tomorrow's third place game. I'm Jeff Taylor, joined by Shona Thorburn. And it feels like this FIBA Women's Eurobasket, Shona, has really come to life in the last couple of days.
Yeah, you know, especially with the quarterfinals, and then today we have had excellent games, really, Jeff, that have come down to the wire. That's been a fight. And I think this is going to be another one of those classics. The gym is almost full here. It's going to be a great crowd for the Serbian home side. But you know what? They're going up against the defending champions, the bronze medalists from last year's FIBA World Cup. And again, you mentioned it, Ana Davidović, I think, is the big question mark in this game. She was quoted as saying, "I'm going to play no matter what, even if I only have one hand." That's a fighter. But she's going up against a strong Spain team, and I think they're just going to force her to use that injured left hand. And, you know, anyone who's scouted Ana Davidović, she really loves, and she's very strong at going to her left to a pull-up and knocking down that pull-up. I don't know if she's going to be able to dribble to her left and get into that pull-up as comfortably as she would like to with that broken hand.
Well, the players are being introduced here, and this is the, you know, Serbian basketball has had so many big moments. The women's game in recent times, Eurobasket Women 2015, where they won the title in Hungary. The following year, they played at the Olympics, and they won the bronze medal. So where does this fall in that? Well, you get to host a women's Eurobasket. You get to play it in the Belgrade Arena. And you get to a semifinal, you're playing for the medals. So this is right up there. Maybe this will be every bit as special as playing at the Olympics. But don't forget, because they played so well, they're actually going to be in the Olympic qualifying tournament next year already. So Marina Maljković, I think clearly she's the perfect fit for this team. They've done a wonderful job. And you feel like when you're in Serbia, this is basketball land, don't you? So it's been a great women's Eurobasket. Now we're going to pause for the playing of the national anthems. Well, it's always great seeing the national anthems and the passion and everything that goes with that. And the players meet at midcourt, the referees, we're going to get a look at them. Sonja Petrovic, the Jar guy, all of these are big time names in international basketball, and we're getting ready to watch them. These are big time names. The referees, Maj Kazuku Forsberg from Denmark, Vasiliki Sarucha of Greece, and Amy Bonner of the United States. And the fact that they're doing this game in and of itself means they've done a pretty good job at this FIBA Women's Eurobasket.
Yeah, like you said, you know, the referees, they get evaluated every game, and to be in, you know, you're one of the top six referees to referee the semifinals, so it's a huge honor for them as well.
Spain have won all five previous meetings between these teams at the Eurobasket, including four with a double-digit margin. And they've already faced each other at this stage. It was in 2013, and Spain won that one 88-69 in France on their way to lifting the trophy that year. Serbia have a star-studded roster. Sonja Petrovic, Sasha Chado, Jelena Brooks, Kevin Dakic. You've got also Anna Dabovic, and it's just a wonderful play, Navina Jovanovic. So you've got Anna Dabovic, Servan Dakic, Brooks, who used to be Jelena Milovanovic, Jovanovic, and Petrovic in the starting five. That is a lot of experience in the starting five.
Yeah, you nailed it. I mean, that woman right there, Petrovic, she already has a game winner in this tournament. She's averaging 11.5 points, 2.3 assists, 4.8 rebounds. But really, there's so many players on that Serbian team who can step up and be the scorer, be the leader. We saw it in the last game with Ana Dabovic's performance, especially in the first half. And then, you know what? Spain also has an incredible roster.
Yeah, absolutely. Laura Nichols never gets enough credit. We try to give it to her. Silvia Dominguez, another veteran, Cristina Zubina, number five. Laia Palau, the ageless wonder at 40 years old, playing as well as ever. Marta Jargai, Anna Cruz, Tamara Baldi's actually come in and played with her. Laura Gill, and of course, Astrid Indoor is in that starting five, probably an MVP candidate for this tournament. But Cruz, Jargai, Palau, Nichols, and Indoor. And it really is a joy watching this player, Astu Indoor, moving from strength to strength for so long, really kind of almost had her way blocked into the senior team as a naturalized player because of Sancho Little. But now she has kind of made that her spot and just gets better and better. Marina Malkovic has been there for all the good times of Serbia.
The championship, 2015.
The daughter of a legend, really, Boza Malkovic. And Lucas Mondello has really no equals when it comes to women's basketball, certainly not in Spain, where he's just led them to their greatest, really their greatest moments.
Yeah, you know, we kind of joke that any team that Lucas Mondello is a part of seems to be lifting a trophy at the end of the tournament or the end of the season for the past few years. I mean, you know, it wasn't just a fluke. He's been around.
Well, Shona, you know, this is Spain's, you see Jorge Garbajosa, the Spain legend, a member of their men's team, 2006 when they won the world title in Japan. He's now the Federation president. So you got former greats, men players, who are actually at the helm of these federations. You've got Secretary General Dejan Tomašević, who's at the helm of Serbia's federation, as well as Saša Danilović, or Predrag Danilović, who's the president of that federation.
And don't forget Spain. You have Elisa Aguilar, who, longtime point guard, lots of titles to her name. She is a big part of the FBB, the Spanish Basketball Federation, as well.
Yep, so it makes sense to have all of these greats there. You know, this will be Spain's 10th appearance in the semifinal of a women's Eurobasket, and they've won four of their previous nine, but have never won a semifinal game
side
in
to two side.
Consecutive
side
Eurobasket.
To
so
right, ready?
Something has to give here. Well, hello, everybody. Good evening. It is the Belgrade Arena, the site of the biggest international basketball game going on right now, that's for sure, between Spain and Serbia. And the winner will advance to tomorrow's final to play France, who just beat Great Britain in a wonderful game. And Astu Endor gets Spain off and running. And, of course, it was Laia Palau that was taking the ball up the floor. So Spain in the white and Serbia in the blue and attacking the basket to the left. Petrovic. I tell you, Serbia really laid the wood to Sweden in their quarterfinal. This is not going to be as easy of a game. Spain, number two in the FIBA ranking for women. Endor goes up and is fouled.
And you know, we even kind of questioned Spain coming out of group play. It wasn't necessarily some of their best basketball. But 2 days ago in the quarterfinals, they just kicked it to another level.
Against Russia. Well, Sweden beat Russia today to get a spot in the Women's Olympic qualifying tournament. Congratulations to Sweden. And Belgium also won their game against Hungary to make it to next year's Women's Olympic qualifiers. Now here's Jargai missing and Palau hustling and saving it in bounds to Anna Dabovic, who's guarded by Anna Kruth.
And you know, no surprise here, they're going to force her to try and use her left hand all night long.
Anna Dabovic drives in. She will not be denied, folks. I tell you what, she's already well on her way to legendary status in Serbia, and this is only going to intensify that feeling that she's playing with a broken bone in her hand. Nichols catches it down low and is fouled. Nichols, so good, and Serbia may be fortunate that she didn't go to the line for a potential three-point play. The foul was on Petrovic. Palau also, as Nichols makes this, has just made history. She's now appeared in 67 games in the women's Eurobasket, the most for any player in the in this century anyway. The miss, ball goes out of bounds, and Spain will retain it. Collision. Well, Astu Endor has come out firing, playing hard. She catches it down low, takes it out. Had a hand in the face shooting that. And good job by Jargai reaching over and throwing the ball off of Jovanovic.
And Jeff, that's already the fourth offensive rebound for Spain in the first 2 minutes of this contest. We saw them pull down 22 offensive rebounds in their quarterfinal game. So really, they've come out again with that mentality. They want to give themselves second chance opportunities.
Well, these teams get after you on defense. They're the only two teams averaging 10 plus steals per game in this Eurobasket. So expect to see some intensity, and Petrovic traps Nichols over there, pressures her and forces her out of bounds. Jovanovic gets it to Petrovic. What a great crowd tonight. What a celebration for women's basketball. Good defense. Laia Palau knocking it away. Brooks fouled in the lane.
And you know, keep in mind, Brooks, she had a baby 3 months ago. For her to one, be back in time, but also be at the level that she is at, it's almost like she didn't miss a beat. She did not play the entire professional season this year.
It is a remarkable story, really, and she shows you that golden form there, that free throw. And when you see a crowd like this, you can understand why she was not taking any chances. She was going to be ready. All the support that she received from the Federation, the doctors. Look at that full court pressure. So the Dakic putting the pressure on Žargaj. Lai Palau over to Žargaj. Good! The three-pointer. Remember, this is a Spain team playing without Alba Torrens, who decided to take this summer off. She's the MVP of the last FIBA Women's EuroBasket that Spain won by beating France in the final in the Czech Republic. Jovanović, tough shot. Great box out by Servan Dakic, and she's fouled by the player she was boxing out, Palau.
And you know, the intensity on defense that Serbia like to play, they like to take risks, they like to try and go for steals, makes people play fast, but you don't really want Spain to play fast because they are so skilled and almost scary. They don't mind playing fast. They don't mind playing a little fancy. So it almost plays into their favor.
Well, the pass into the corner to Jovanović. Brooks with the rebound. She goes right up against Endur. Endur just stood there with her arms raised. Now Cruz to Endur. And Endur stayed with it, but missed it again. Now quickly to the other end goes Serbia. Oh, Dabovic, nice move, and then she scores.
And that's what I'm talking about. She likes to go to her left to get to her pull-up. And, you know, I question maybe her ability with that broken left hand. And, well, she proved me wrong. Foot in mouth.
Yeah, Tomaszewicz taking exception to the defense being played by Cruz on Dabovic. Now Jovanović rebounds the miss. Boy, this pace is, the physicality is there for all to see. Now Dabovic going up against Palau. This is a real fight. Offensive foul called by Sarucha, the Greek referee, as Dabovic goes tumbling down.
I mean, she might have sold it a little bit. There you see that, what I talked about, her little dribble to the left into a pull-up. That is kind of Dabovic's go-to move.
Servan Dakic really battling with Žargaj. Palau pushing quickly. Again, it's worth reminding everybody, 40 years of age Palau, and she looks as quick, as strong, and fast as ever. We thought she was retiring after the last Women's EuroBasket, but she decided to keep playing. Nichols misses, and Servan Dakic, nobody around her, but fumbled the ball out of bounds. She's the really the bright hope of Serbian basketball now, for Serbia, certainly. Servan Dakic. So Silvia Dominguez checks in for Palau.
You know, like you said, that is Palau's 67th EuroBasket game.
And Cruz, who famously hit that shot against Turkey at the end of their Olympic quarterfinal in Rio 2 years ago, shows that form. She hasn't been in the greatest form, but she's coming to life here, hasn't she? Petrovic drives in. Dabovic, well, maybe trying to do a little too much there, turns it over to Cruz, and then Brooks sees the pass and cuts it off. And now Nichols reaches in and takes it away.
Well, this game is incredibly physical.
Yeah. This pace is electric.
Yes, the pace and physicality is...
Thank you. Pass to Endur. Gives it to Nichols. Now Žargaj. Watch the Žargaj-Jovanović matchup. That's intriguing. As is this one. Cruz shoots it high. Davidovich. I can see Davidovich getting a double-double, triple-double. Nope. Endur sneaks behind her. Knocks it away. Now Cruz takes no time to get it down the floor. Žargaj from the left corner. Turnovers are punished. And Marina Maljkovic calls timeout as Spain surge ahead into an 11-6 lead.
Yeah, and I think, you know, we talked about how fast this game is going right now. I think it's more in favor of Spain, this pace of game, this style of game. And, you know, Serbia are only shooting 2 of 11. And like you said, 3 turnovers.
Well, 2 threes already for Spain. Žargaj already has 6 points. Her tournament high is 31 on opening night against Ukraine.
And there you have the fast break points. Like I said, I think this pace suits Spain more, and you know, 5-0 fast break is my point exactly. And we saw in the quarterfinals, Žargaj had what, 10 points in the first half, and then she didn't really need to score in the second half. It's such control. Other people sort of took over, asked to Endur.
There she is, and I was struck by seeing Žargaj here and walking up next to her. She's really a lot bigger than you realize.
Yeah, she's tall.
She's a tough player.
Yeah.
And what's interesting about her for me is she's quick and she's skilled offensively, but her defense is second to none. I mean, she gets after you. So she is a complete player. Sylvia Dominguez.
So that's the 4th foul on Spain.
14th foul, yep. Matic has checked in. Number 13. And Brooks has always been a great shooter.
It was a beautiful set play. She had that famous shot 2 years ago in the FIBA EuroLeague final. Remember, in the Final Four, in the semifinal for Chapon to win the game and have them play in the final.
She's had a long and successful career, and a lot of her best moments have come playing for Chapon.
Yeah.
Christina Uvina in the game now. Number 5. Takes the handoff. Dominguez. Bounce pass. Endur. Boy, that just cut them open, didn't they?
Yeah. It was beautiful penetration. Need an even better execution and pass from Sylvia Dominguez.
Brooks waits, and Davidovich sneaks in on the weak side.
There's actually quite a few mums in this tournament, Jeff. Sylvia Dominguez has a child. Brooks has a child, yeah. And Waters, Bria Hartley. Well, it's kind of cool. You know, a lot of times people ask female athletes, you know, how do you do both? And it is difficult to be able to come back and be at the same level or even better than before the child. So it's cool to see all these parents.
Wow, look at her get down the floor like a bullet out of a gun, Sylvia Dominguez.
And I think she's had a pretty solid tournament for them so far.
Now quickly up to Davidovich, and then fouled and gets to the line.
You know, we know last year the World Cup in Spain, Sylvia was kind of hampered by an injury, so I don't think it was the best tournament for her. She wasn't 100% healthy.
Well, it's very clear that even with the broken bone, you see Indoor born out of the game, even with the broken bone in her left hand, Ana Davidovic is not going to change the way she plays.
No. And the kind of competitor that, that Ana Davidovic is, did, would we expect anything different?
No. Not at all. MVP of the Women's Eurobasket in 2015. Abigail in and boxing out, and the ball knocked out of bounds, so it'll be Spain ball. Doing it quickly. Out of kill. Now it's our guy. Millis drives in. That was an impressive move. Just didn't finish. Dominga again. Oh, boy. She's come to play. Now the steal. Uvina back to Dominguez. And she probably could have gone in for the layup. So Serbia dodged a bullet there. Well, Milic clearing out. Looked like she may have caught Žargaj in the neck. Watch this underneath the basket. Well.
Much of a.
I mean,
Žargaj ran into her arm.
She may have touched her. It looked like, I thought she maybe had taken a shot. Oh, Dominguez again getting in there and scoring 6 points in a row for Sylvia Dominguez. To 11 in favor of the defending champions. Now Milic. She's getting in good spots.
Yeah,
she's just not finishing. Stanichev, number 20, also in. And once again, Sylvia Dominguez showing us why she was once considered the top young player in Spain and has been a member of this national team program for so long. I mean, this is the best run offensively by Dominguez that I can ever remember seeing in this Spain senior team. Those were her seventh and eighth points. She is leading them in scoring. Spain on top 21-11.
Stats after 10 minutes. There you see it. 44% for Spain, only 27. 2 of 5. Those 2 3-pointers for Žargaj. But like you said, it was really Sylvia Dominguez who took over.
One of the timeouts, I was reliably informed by somebody that was listening in that Marina Malkovic, the coach of Serbia, was telling her players, we are not the ones that are attacking, they are the ones attacking us. That was during the first 5 minutes. And then she said, that's a shame. So I guess that's
It's true.
You can't back off Spain. You got to get after them as well.
Yeah, exactly. Put pressure on them defensively, but I still think they need to be good shots.
Yeah.
And I think Serbia kind of forced a few shots that led to easy rebounds, and Spain were able to play fast. And like I said, Spain in the open court, Spain playing fast, that's playing into what they want to do.
Spain finished third at the World Cup last year that they hosted in Tenerife. Serbia did not qualify for that. Dominguez for three. And Tamar Abalde.
There's the Miss Spain.
Spain Universe or whatever?
Yeah, 2017. Those who follow Twitter will see some of her posts about this tournament. She has been around. She was in Riga interviewing players, promoting the sport, the women's game.
I'm just going to show how popular it is. Nicolia. In the game, number 10 has the ball. Chajo as well is in, number 6, and now the ball knocked away by Abalde out of the hands of Milic. And Serbia right now teetering against the number 2 team in the world. Jargaj. Uvina. Dominguez. Baseline pulls up. Couldn't quite get that one to drop. And it'll be Serbia ball. How, you know, if you're a girl that want to play, you want to play basketball, and you see Dominguez playing like this, it must tell you, you know what? I may not be as big as some of the other girls, but there's a place for me out on the basketball court.
Absolutely. Now, like you said, she's been around on the Spanish team for a long time.
Nowhere to go. Dina stepped out of bounds. Great defense by Petrovic.
And this is how good this Spain team is. Other than Chargaj, the starting five are able to get a break and a breather. Because really, even when the bench players go in, they don't lose anything.
Oh, impressive move by Dragana Stankovic. The shot seems to have given Serbia some life. Chajo called for a foul. And we're getting another look at the depth with Carol Casas coming in for Spain, number 18. Nichols also back in the game, as well as Cruz. Casas, oh, what a rebound from Nichols. But then she's fouled by Stankovic. Stankovic. And Stankovic got the worst of that, it seems. Watch the hand. I couldn't see it there. But at the other end, Stankovic's move was something maybe that Serbia will want to go to again. Remember, Spain have never won two consecutive FIBA Women's Eurobaskets in a row. Nichols takes her time and makes one of two.
No team has ever won two consecutive Eurobaskets in a row. So Spain are trying to make history.
Oh, Buccalia takes it all the way.
By, you know, topping the podium at this year's Eurobasket.
Dominguez.
If she had hit that, I think I would have stood up and cheered as well. She has just come out and been a difference maker for this Spanish team.
Here's Stankovic again, turns, scores! X-Factor. Lucas Mondello calls timeout. This is a strong move. And we've seen it twice here. So that gets it back to 22-17.
Hay que tener paciencia porque nos van a dar leche, si no están pitando nada, seguimos atacando y al final intento atacar, si no hay nada, aparición, tiro libre, la cambio de lado y vuelvo a atacar. ¿Vale? ¿De acuerdo?
Very even with the assist and the turnovers.
El ataque. Vamos a jugar diferentes sistemas, ¿vale?
Postavi napad, ne vas kontru, postavi napad. Pokušaj glavu pre nego što postaviš napad. A onda sve, tri nismo igrali, dole nismo igrali. Jedan pet, majica, sasa nismo igrali. Ali ako i dalje ova, može Dragane Lopta, da ne selimo. I prodirite više čvrsto unutra.
Stankovic has come into the game and made quite an impact. She came into this game for Serbia. Her best game was in the opening one against Belarus, where she scored 7 points. She also had three against Belgium, and that was all of her scoring. So she looks like a real threat as she catches the ball close to the basket.
She has a little bit of a height advantage over Louder Nichols, who's trying to guard her.
Kind of get the feeling that Spain have thrown some mean punches and that Serbia have hung around and now they're getting back into it.
That's a perfect example of Serbia's defense that frustrates and forces teams into turnovers. You saw Dabović go for the steal. She didn't get the steal, but it made Silvia Dominguez play faster than she wanted to play, and she just, you know, overthrew the pass to Kassas.
Petrovic, ooh, falling down. And Cruz takes it and hangs in the air, and now we'll go to the line. So she makes it, and now a potential three-point play. This is a quality finish. She knows the contact is coming, so she has a chance to prepare for that type of finish. I mean, we've seen her do that so many times. Dabović, not farther in the least, in the slightest. Oh boy, Stankovic that time called for a foul, getting position. Second foul on Stankovic and Cruz cuts across the paint. Now Casas. Oh, that was a tough finish by Quero Casas. Petrovic gets in deep and draws the foul from Gil. This is the beautiful the spider cam.
It's actually really fun to watch in person, the spider
cam. It is.
I mean, the angle that you see on TV is pretty incredible, but we get a little bit of both because we have the TV screen and then we get to enjoy the movements of the spider cam.
It's kind of mesmerizing.
It is. It moves with such ease.
Petrovic makes both free throws. Here 5 for Spain at the line. Serbia 5 of 6. Spain knows that they don't want to be playing against this crowd, so they've done a great job of getting on top, kind of trying to put the crowd out of it. Chacho goes over to the bench.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of people here. You could hear them on TV.
Casas does struggle with her free throws.
I wouldn't say it's one of her strengths. We saw that wonderful take left-handed by her. That is a strength of hers, going to the left, to the basket.
Both. Now, Jargaard's going to come back into the game, and I don't know if it's going to be for Casas. She knows she's got to work on that aspect of the game.
And you know, in the last few years, I think her outside shooting, she's always been great at attacking the basket, finishing around the basket, but her outside shooting for me has really, really impressed.
Jovanović, good! Now, Petrolia goes down the Serbian crowd.
She got rocked by a screen in the backcourt by that woman, Laura Nichols, I believe it was.
And then you see the scrap there.
Fans behind us are letting us know how they feel about that call.
Well, they're getting back into it. You can feel it, the momentum. It's almost irrepressible. And Petrolia drives in and draws the foul. So she will get a couple free throws. They're definitely up in their game right now, Serbia. And there's Jovanović and all the French team just chilling out. Joannis
just hit that nice shot.
Had the 20 points for France.
France want to find out who they are going to be playing in the gold medal game tomorrow evening.
The miss and the scrap for the loose ball. So the Spain ball, they're tied up. Dominguez goes back out, and now Avina comes back in. Brings it to midcourt. Spain looking to reestablish control here. The Serbia creeping back. Out of guilt. If you're Serbia, you let her have that, surely. And Cruz instead gets the ball and shoots.
I think the fans are complaining about a travel by Laura Gil, but...
Oh, what a finish that time by Pupulia.
Really, you know, you helped off Cruz a little bit too much, and she, like you said, is a lot more deadly from the outside than Laura Gil is.
Up that time, and Pupulia has it. It's a 5-point deficit facing Serbia. Petrovic catches and goes hard, and Gil blocks her. Brooks comes back into the game for Stankovic. Petrovic has to let it fly with the shot clock winding down. Still Spain leading by 5. Cruz knifes her way in. Oh, what a finish. Did you see the English put on that? 9 points for Cruz. Brooks getting tangled up with Marta Jargay. What spin that was. That was by design, wasn't it? Well, the quick pass to Pupulia. She's been tough. She's finished well.
She has. She's done a great job of coming off the bench, you know, giving Anna Dabovic a little bit of a breather.
Well, one of those veterans. I mean, this is a veteran team.
Yep.
Poor guy. Oh, what a catch and finish by Laura Gil. Wow.
That was tough.
Brooks into Cervandakić. Serbia needing a stop. Cruz again. There's not going to be a let off from Spain. Oh. She's changed her call. She initially said it was going to be Serbia ball, but now Slaruka quite rightly says it is Spain ball.
That was a good job by Laura Gil, just kind of sticking around after the made basket by Cruz. Cruz getting a well-deserved
rest.
Well,
she's been terrific tonight.
She looks fatigued.
I can't remember when she's played this well, to be honest.
It's been a while. She hasn't put up big numbers in the last couple of years in EuroLeague either. Was quiet last year at the World Cup.
Now, that was a tough shot from Nichols on the baseline. Lead goes back to 9 for Spain. She's already surpassed the tournament high as Anna Cruz. She hit 9 points against Great Britain and Latvia. Nichols has it. Kuzina. It's got to happen on this end for Serbia defense if they can get offense from their defense. That's where they really start to cause problems. That time Laura Gil late in the shot clock flung one up there. Didn't have much of a chance to go in. Petrovic. Oh, boy. You saw the opening for Brooks. Is that Petrovic?
Petrovic, yeah.
He's already down the court pretty quickly.
Good job. She realized the mismatch. I think it was Kassas trying to guard her.
And here's the defense almost getting that turnover and fast break, but instead Spain get it. Nichols misses and Pupulia. has it. Now the dump. Ivanovic and now Petolia. Oh, Petolia almost walked. Petrovic gets it back.
Again, Petrovic with a little bit of a height advantage here.
Finds Petolia in the right corner. Oh, great hustle from Servan Dakic to get it back. And Petolia went up for the shot. Ball was blocked and fell into the hands of a teammate who was out of bounds, Servan Dakic. So Dabovic checks back in for the final 45 seconds or so, also checking in number 24, Michael Smorgic. Short guy. Nichols reaching over. Yeah, it looked like it might have been over the back.
Good job trying to keep the ball alive, but.
Dabovic. Turns. Didn't get a good shot there. Now Spain have enough time, and Lucas Modelo says one shot. Dominguez goes in amongst the land of the trees and is denied, but Spain take 37-30 lead at halftime here in the second semifinal of the FIBA Women's Eurobasket.
They're shooting 43%, which is really good. They're 0-3. Spain went cold from the three. They hit those two shots early. You know, look at that, though. Offensive rebounding. Wow. 9 from Spain, but then again, 7 for Serbia. Assists. Look, 6 steals to just 2. And typically, I would say Serbia, because the way they play defense, how they gamble so much, they normally come up on the better side of that statistical category, but here it is at Spain. Here you see the leaders, Cruz, who really came alive in that second quarter for them. Butelia, I thought, has been great for Serbia off the bench. Silvia Dominguez, here you see her with 2 of her 8 points. She was another key player off the bench for Spain. Really, it's kind of been about the role players stepping up. We have Ana Cruz, who's been kind of quiet so far in this tournament. Butelia, Stankovic came in and did a good job for Serbia. You know, I thought Ana Dabovic started well. We all know that she is playing with that broken hand. I'm not sure if it's affecting her. She hasn't played as much as, you know, we have seen really in this tournament. Maybe coach is saving her a little bit, or they are trying to protect that hand. I'm not really sure. I think what, you know, when you play a little bit out of control, or, you know, you lose your defensive assignment, Spain are one of the best teams in the world of punishing you. So either offensively or defensively, you know, if you try and cheat on defense and you don't follow, or, you know, you're supposed to play a specific type of defense on someone and you don't do it, that's where Spain are exceptionally good at making you pay. And the same goes on the offensive end. I feel, you know, Spain, if you don't do something well, Spain are going to come up with a steal, or they're going to come up with an easy rebound that leads to Spain running and playing great basketball. When Spain get out and run, I think they're sort of at their most dangerous. We saw that early. I think Serbia did a good job of calming down and not allowing that as much. But honestly, I don't think it was the best basketball for Serbia the first 20 minutes, and to only be down 7 to a team that I think Cruz played well, Chargai came out and played great, Dominguez stepped up for them. Astuendor's been a little quiet. She had those two fouls and had to go to the bench, Jeff. So really, I'm not too upset if I'm Serbia. I'm not too worried either. You know, you're only down 7 against a top team in the world.
Well, that's a great analysis. And remember, the winner advances to play France. France have the luxury of now sitting back and watching, although I think they may have gone now. Or maybe they've gone to get a drink and they'll be back in a second. So the loser will play Great Britain in the third place game. And we're going to take a break now, and we'll be right back before the start of the second half. It's Spain leading at 37-30 over Serbia in the second semifinal.
Trokora.
it up and makes it, and they have got the wind in their sails, Spain. Messina brings it across midcourt, and she takes the bump, and she's going to get a three-point play opportunity.
That's a tough fake by Messina.
Scarpio, oh, no-look pass, nice finish by Rahman. Well, that was well done by Carpio. Backman Lee is going to take on Hattar. What a move to the basket.
So far, Backman Lee has been able to score anywhere on the court against this Hungarian defense.
Diayi for three. Oh, it rims out. Messman knocks out the Hartley. She takes a three. She hits it. She has tied the contest. Anna Dabovic, 7 points, 3 of 6 from the floor, 3 rebounds. I mean, she's played hard. She's contributed. It's just very difficult right now, but I'll tell you what, there's a lot of inspiration in that performance that she's given her teammates by coming out with the broken bone in her hand, her left hand, which is wrapped up. Her team trailing 37-30 against Spain, and I've got a feeling there's going to be more twists in the tail here in the second half, but don't go away. Serbia, remember, will be roared on by this home court crowd.
Yeah, you know, they're behind them, and that's the advantage of hosting an event like this. And players feed off of that energy that the crowd gives them. I think maybe you know, referees could be swayed by the noise that the crowds are making sometimes if they agree or disagree with the call and things like that. So it is encouraging, you know, it's almost like that sixth man out there on the court with you, all these fans, and this is what you play for. I mean, to have this kind of a tournament and this opportunity to play at home in front of friends, family, and fans.
You also saw there were some Spanish fans here.
Spanish faithful.
Spanish faithful. Some of the family members as well would come for tonight to see their favorite team. Spain won the last 43 Eurobasket games where they were leading by more than 2 points at halftime, so that factoid will not be encouraging news for the Serbia faithful. But rest assured, none of those games were played here in Belgrade. Serbia come right out of the gates and score to cut that deficit back to 5 points, and it was, guess who, Dabovic. But Spain so good at reacting and responding immediately. Get it through Nichols. Beautiful pass and finish from Brooks.
You know, for so long, it was Milovanovic, and it's a little unusual to get used to calling her Brooks because she is so well known in the women's game, and you know her as Milovanovic.
That's right. Kyle missed. I'm not sure that was what Lucas Mondello wanted. Because now Serbia have a chance to get even closer, to cut it to three or maybe even two. And then under pressure, Petrovic throws the ball over the head of Dabovic. Resting her for the second half, but although
it's Sylvia Dominguez,
I was about to say the players that came in got the job done. And now Dabovic called for a foul on Laia Palau. The shot and hits it from the line.
How many times have we seen that? You know, Serbia almost come up with a steal, and then it's almost like a dagger because Spain seems to always hit that shot.
Well, Ivan Dakic, however, serves one up for Serbia. The team trading baskets. Up allowed to Indur. He turns left and then turns right. Oh, I sure thought it was the pass that she meant to make, but it ended up with Petrovic because she missed with the left hand. Cruz floats in. They just have shifted into a higher gear tonight.
They really have. It started yesterday, and it has continued on, if not even a little bit better from yesterday's game. I mean, Anna Cruz has almost been perfect tonight.
Good rebound from Servan Dakic. Over to Davidovic, short. And Serbia just really in danger, and you wonder if Malkovic might get a timeout or will she get a sub? She's going to put Stankovic back in the game.
I mean, Stankovic did a great job when she came in, I thought, the first half.
She'll bring her in for Petrovic. And Nikolia is going to come in for Servan Dakic. Spain, 29% from three-point range, 2 of 7. Serbia have yet to hit one. Double dribbles the call, so they get it right back. This crowd trying to will this Serbian team on. And Lyapalau reaches in and commits to personal. Spain's first in the third quarter. And just like in the first half, she takes a seat and Silvia Dominguez comes in. Well, Stankovic had it and decided to pass it. I think the crowd, you heard the murmurs, like, why haven't you shot it? But she knew what she was doing. So, that was Palau's third foul, as you can see. And now Cruz comes up. Ivanovic had her hands up on this coming up with a steal. Good catch from Indur. And foul as she was guarded by Stankovic and Davidovic. Stankovic gets the foul. Number three.
But then after that, she started to get going. But she picked up her second foul and had to go to the bench for most of the first half.
That's right. Now Gargai reaches in, almost forces the turnover. She just has an engine that never stops, Marty Gargai. So timeout on the floor. Spain have been able to increase their lead to 9 points since halftime.
So the rebounding numbers pretty even. And Spain
Spain with six steals to Serbia's two.
Sí, Milovanovic y Lazo.
Sí, cambio. ¿De acuerdo? Tenemos claro. Solo con la 10. Vale. Hey, jugamos, acuérdate, Solner.
Ana Cruz with 13 points. Her best game of the tournament. And why do you think she is so effective? She just has that uncanny ability to be able to knife her way into the lane.
Yeah, she's incredibly quick, and she's also really crafty. But I think what gives her the ability to be able to get all the way to the basket for those nice finishes that we saw is her pull-up. Her pull-up jumper is incredibly effective. She's hit game winners with that kind of a shot. So you have to respect that at the same time, which means you have to get a little bit closer, and she's smart enough to be able to, and quick enough to be able to go by people if they're guarding her a little too close.
And then she's a pest on defense. Butolia has really come to the fore for Serbia tonight. She answers.
You know, really for Serbia though, you kind of feel like they make great plays, but they don't get consecutive stops in a row. You know, they'll get one stop, get a score.
Oh, look at that. Double team comes, somebody's open. Yeah. Well, the feed to Petrovic. Back to Stankovic, maybe a little bit too far out. She wants to be closer to the basket, but she had that shot earlier, and she's like, here, Sonya, you take it. And that was the shot before she got off in time. Žargaj, a break for Spain. That one seemed to be on its way down. And now the fans are upset because they called a jump ball.
It was a quick jump ball.
Ten offensive rebounds for Spain, eight for Serbia. Dominguez with the left hand. Maj Forsberg says the star guy was out of bounds. This is where it's so difficult for teams that when a player gets a break, like Cruz, Mondello brings in a player like Uvina, although she probably doesn't have quite the offensive skills, at least from the jump shot variety.
You know, if you watch her in EuroLeague play the past couple of years with Boris, though.
She was able to hit him?
Yeah, she was. Very capable of knocking down three-pointers, pull-up jumpers.
Stankovic got back on the scoreboard. And again, Serbia refusing to go away.
But again, I keep saying they need to get multiple consecutive stops in a row, and they just have not been able to do that yet.
Virginia, let's see that jump shot. Oh, you were almost right. It went in and out.
Another offensive rebound for Spain.
Žargaj just goes hard to the basket. Look at that. Relentless comes to mind. That's the word. Petolia into Stankovic. She turns again. It's fouled! Well, if anything, at least Serbia seemed to be finding an important weapon for the rest of this tournament and in the future. Only 24 years of age, Dragana Stankovic. And remember, her previous high coming into this game was 7 points against Belarus.
I mean, you have Stankovic, you have Kevin Dakic. Serbian basketball is still, you know, there's a reason why they're playing in the semifinals.
Butolia,
I mean, they have some exciting young players as well.
Well, she's got 9 points now, and Uvina comes down, and just like you said, Shona, she can shoot it from long range.
But do you remember that game last year for Spain. It was Cristina Avina and Coral Casas who started against Canada, started knocking down the shots when Spain needed someone to score.
That's right. I had forgotten that. And you're right, it's Avina with a tilde on the end. I think I was thinking more for last game, which was one of seven from the floor, and then the game against Latvia, she was just one of five. She hadn't been shooting it well in this tournament, but here she is, Stankovic, and draws the foul again. And the crowd appealing for an unsportsmanlike. They could go look at it if they wanted, and I think they might. They're going to go take a look. Yep, here they come. So let's listen in as they go over. Here it is again.
I think it's with her, not the right hand. I think they're saying she kind of grabbed her with her left hand on the drive.
We can listen in.
Can you go back one more time?
Go back a little bit. With the left hand.
I don't think it's enough. You good with the common?
Yeah.
Common foul. Number four, right?
Well, the decision is not to award the unsportsmanlike. I'm not comfortable with that call, and I'll tell you, it just looked like, I don't know, maybe they're saying it wasn't intentional that her left arm was holding down the right arm. But it didn't look good to me. It looked a bit excessive.
But kind of funny because when the foul shot was called, Laura Nichols looked at the ref like, what?
Yeah, but
which
that's
is
the normal.
Typical. They're very typical of the Spanish.
Yeah. They do not commit fouls. Well, at least Serbia catch a break there as Ruth tried to save it in bounds. And Lucas Mondello is now going to draw the ire of the crowd. And now they are going to reward. They're going to give the ball back to Spain. I think this is the right call because she throws
good job.
It off
she,
of her.
She was in bounds when she took that last jump and then was able to throw it off.
But certainly the crowd starting to get unsettled here by a couple of these calls. And it is a loud crowd. Now Petolia blocks Dominguez as she comes in from the left. Good play defensively there.
You can hear the fans.
And leaving her feet with nowhere to go, Dominguez throws it into the hands of Servan Dakic. And now Cruz reaches in and fouls Petolia.
Lucas Mondello. Look, you see him, he's trying to get his players to hustle in. I think he wants to talk to them, and this is a calm down timeout. It might not have a whole lot of structure about what to do, but it's, you know what, calm down, play your style, this is what we're going to do. He's getting a little chippy.
Yeah.
Estaba bien lo que has hecho. Ese saque de fondo no. Hay que abrirla afuera y jugar un pick and pop. Y una de las dos se queda sola, tía. es pérdida y corre, no pérdida. Al menos perdemos tirando un tiro. Vale.
Cruz leading the scoring.
Vamos a jugar.
Although it's a balanced attack.
Vamos a jugar shoulder. De acuerdo. Los bloqueos. El segundo bloqueo.
El polaco pasa de arriba y orma de tres, Nefri. Visto tanto grande mi protivobi. Cuatro mi posición, no hasta mi uso.
And really the names that are missing there. You'd be looking for more points from Brooks. And maybe even Petrovic.
Yeah. I think Brooks has been quiet. Anna Dabovic, she only has 2 points so far in this quarter. But again, Dabovic playing less minutes than we're used to seeing. She does have that broken hand that we know about. And the woman that's on the line.
Ooh.
Has, you know, minus that miss, I think done a very good job coming in and being a replacement for Anna Dabovic. You'd like to see Petrovic and Brooks maybe take over here.
Ooh, two brutal misses, but Stankovic and now Petrovic. Again, they stay after it. Serban Dakic, again, another rebound. Butolia for three. And a foul called on Spain on the box out. On Nichols. Not sure what it was.
But you know what? It's not the time to complain. Momentum isn't really in Spain's favor right now. But saying that, I don't think Serbia has taken advantage of the momentum shift either.
That was Predrag Danilovic kind of leaning forward on his knees with his hands in his face, or his face in his hands, rather. And this is the worrying aspect. As Cruz goes out, Žargaj comes in. This is, some people said this was Žargaj's Eurobasket to be the leader with Alba Torrens out.
I think I had her in my top five at the beginning of this, before the tournament started.
And is she there now?
I don't know. We've had some pretty big performances.
Ah. There's no end to the number of players
that are capable.
That are capable, yeah. of stroking big shots for Spain. Twelve turnovers now against Serbia. Žargaj pulls up, and I like how Stankovic is playing. She's really asserting herself on both ends of the floor. And turnover and a foul on Bukolia.
That's two turnovers by Bukolia. You know, I don't know if Coach Malkovich would want to maybe.
Bring Dabovic back.
Yeah. And they are going to go to a video review and see if this is an unsportsmanlike foul.
If they're rooting for Serbia, they are. Nah. You think it is? It is not going to be well received if they give it, seeing as how they didn't give it
Can
to Serbia
out?
On the last
one. Wide out angle, please.
Make me go.
I think she's playing the ball. Do you?
I think she's playing the ball.
Yep. What is that, number?
Number 10.
Number 10? You good with
yes,
that?
Number 10.
Okay, common foul.
Yeah, so they said, you know, they believe that she was playing the ball. And like you said, I think the crowd would have gone crazy if they had called that an unsportsmanlike, but the one on Lauder Nichols wasn't.
Well, that was probably a call made, which aided stadium security. Tomorrow, Baldy's going to come into the game. Goes right around, but then didn't shoot it, tried to pass it, 3-on-1 break, and Jovanović, instead of going for the shot, tried to make sure there was contact. Yeah. I think she made a mistake. She should have gone to the basket. Look at this. Oh, no, she didn't. Sorry. It was Uvinja.
I think Jovanović brought down the ball and made it easy for Uvinja to, you know, just get a hand on it.
Tolia, good rebound, Petrovic. Uvinja knocks it out of her hands, but it falls. Jovanović, and now Gil over Stankovic commits the foul, and they're over the limit, so free throws for Serbia, so that's not bad.
Serbia shooting 10 of 15. We haven't seen great free throw shooting in the last couple days here in Serbia.
Stankovic has hit 2 of 3 tonight. But 3 of 4.
And Serbia are 0 of 7 from 3.
Wow. And she makes both. They're still right there. Remember the same in the first semifinal, Great Britain, although they led for a lot of the first half. They fell behind, but they never, you know, France never really pulled away from it. The same in this game. See the free throw numbers in this quarter. And Abaldi, almost hooked Petrolia. Dominguez this time dumps it, and what a finish. I mean, that adds insult right there with Pina coming off the bench. And hitting
first
the baseline
touch of
jumper.
The game,
yep,
you know,
first
being
touch.
Able to.
Kevin Dockett pulls up. And she did not get it off in time, Jovanović, so only 10 minutes remain. Serbia's hopes still alive for a spot in the final to face France, but it's those hopes are fading a little bit.
Yeah. Take a quick look at the stats here. Down 8. 10 minutes to play. It really, you know, three-point shooting has not been very strong by either team. Here, Spain shooting 52%. Serbia shooting well, but three-point shooting. Also free throws, I mean, 12 to 17.
Well, for those people looking for little nuggets of information, you can talk about while having coffee tomorrow morning. Marta Jargai has now scored 10-plus points in consecutive Eurobasket games for only the third time in 33 games in the competition. That's surprising, isn't it?
It is, given a person of her stature.
But she's also, got so many great teammates, I guess.
She hasn't had to. I mean, she wasn't the first option ever. So, you know, I think Alba Torrens was kind of the first option, Sancho Little.
Yeah.
So that's, you know, Cruz has had good summers. So really, you know, I would never say that, you know, they've relied on her to score that.
Until now, really.
Yeah.
And just when they start relying on her, Cruz comes up and has her best game of the tournament. But that's a luxury for Mundelo.
Yeah.
And then you have so many other players that we've seen that have been able to step up and make shots. And that's three fouls on Dominguez.
But the beauty about this...
Well, you can't see it, but Dejan Tomaszewicz is asking for Mundelo to get a technical foul call for, I don't know, getting too close to the play or...
And I think he was given a warning.
Right. For Servan Dakic. Turns, goes up, and that was a powerful move from Servan Dakic.
And she's 23 years old. She's actually one of the, I think, more exciting 23-year-olds. I mean, well, Joanna's is 24 now, so.
Well, they have not put this Serbia team away. And now the scrap and the foul. Servan Dakic whistled for the excessive contact.
I was too busy watching. Look at this move. Too busy watching the ball.
She liked it. She liked it. And Nichols. Dominguez again leaves her feet, passes Jargai. Rims out this time. Great box out by Brooks. Formerly known as Yelena Milovanic.
And you know what? She's been quiet. And
well, it's Servan Dakic's time again. She goes up. No foul. And good job defensively that time by Jargai. And what a pass. And it finishes with Andor. Boy, put that on the highlight reel. Spanish basketball. Counterattack. Fantastic pass by Dominguez. And Petoli misses the layup. That is a killer. Again, Dominguez on the break. Over to Cruz. Dominguez again. Ball bounces over Stankovic. Now Indoor out for three. She misses badly.
I think Serbia, you could say, got lucky there.
They did, but...
Gave up three offensive rebounds. Good look by Cruz. Good look by Dominguez. Astu Endor's was a little off.
Yeah, they totally missed that free throw. Here's Stankovic. Turns, puts it up. And they're getting their shots, but now a technical foul has been called. Maj Forsberg has had enough. Look at Mundelo. Complaining about the refereeing, and he's finally been slapped for the technical.
He's still trying to talk to the ref.
I don't know why he's doing this, though, with an 8-point lead. So Brooks at the line, chance to get one of the points back, and she rattles it in, nice one.
So a technical is not like an unsportsmanlike foul where
possession.
It's two shots and the ball. Yeah. Spain did have possession, so they do regain possession.
It used to be that possession changed hands. But that's the rule that's been changed. Dabovic back in the game. Palau back in the game as well. Cruz. Spain missing a couple of shots now. Oh, Dabovic almost loses it.
But you can see she's not comfortable using her left hand. I mean, no. She really is protecting it when she plays.
For the pass it there with the left hand. Now Brooks. Good footwork from Brooks. Now it's back to a 5-point deficit. Serbia trying to dig deep here in front of the home crowd. And a flailing Žargaj misses the shot. Here's a chance for Serbia. Petrovic drives in, can't get it to go, follows. And she just hasn't been up to it tonight. Now Indoor. And she does finish. And I don't know why Petrovic has really struggled offensively.
1 of 8, 4 points. She does have 5 assists to go along with 5 rebounds.
She's missed a lot of shots at the rim. Brooks seems to be carrying him right now.
I mean, Brooks has kind of been quiet. She has the last 4 points for Serbia, but
I don't think they want to forget Serban Dakić. She was pretty effective.
She was, you know, posting up smaller guards who were trying to guard her.
And the fans banging their feet on the ground, and look at this. They're fighting, and Serbia, you could feel the momentum starting to go their way. Dabovic hands it off, and I think you're right. I think it's a struggle for her dribbling with that left hand. Chajo in the game passes over to Serban Dakić, who again gives it to Brooks, and she was pushed by Žargaj. 40-minute game. You got to play all 40 minutes, Spain. And I think the technical was a mistake by Mondello. It seemed to
ignite
that little bit of impetus to the play of Serbia. Got the crowd more involved.
And, you know, that wasn't a big foul on Žargaj, but she had 2 hands when Brooks was going up for the shot on her body. So it was a veteran move and shot by Brooks to realize, you know what, her hands are all over me. I'm just going to chuck this up.
Vale, en el pío pío estamos teniendo buenas ventajas, vale, lo has hecho bien. Cuernos abajo y situaciones. Vamos a empezar con Ser.
See the fast break points in favor of Spain there.
Vamos a esperar salida. Tenemos aclarado, pero bloqueo. Y ahora el pin down, caída.
Serbia had yet to hit a three-pointer.
This tournament, Serbia is shooting a decent 36% from three.
Well, Brooks has come in, and, you know, when we were looking at the leading scores a while ago, she wasn't in the top 4 or 5, but she certainly is now. She's turned it on here.
Free throw shooting has been a little bit of a struggle this game for Serbia.
The 30-year-old goes to the line. She came in averaging 10.8 points in this competition. She's well over that now, up to 13. And really, it's taken the kind of the poise of Brooks, the veteran, to kind of bring this Serbia team this close. I mean, those were no doubt about it free throws.
It was a perfect free throw. They were both swishes. Everything looked good.
This is a pressing defense, a pressing squad that they've got in here. Petolia, Dabovic.
And you know what? That's okay. They only have, what, 1 foul so far in this quarter.
Take
a little bit of a gamble.
Ivanovic is out, watching from the bench. That's one of their better defenders. But she hasn't really...
Offensively, yeah. I think Petulia has done great for them in this game, so I'm not surprised that she's in right now.
And Palau throws it wildly, and Petrovic almost guilty of a hold, trying to keep Nichols out. Nichols complains.
And Palau had to throw that wild pass because it was going to be a backcourt 8-second call.
She's trying to hit Jargai.
Well,
she didn't play quite as well tonight as she did last night. Turnovers now 12 for Spain, 13 for Serbia. Brooks goes right at indoor. Tough shot! Oh, my goodness. That is the shot of the game. We're back to the basket. 1-point lead for Spain now. Cruz on the counterattack. The ball hit to Dabovic. Brooks.
Probably a good idea by Brooks to kind of slow it down.
This place is going to erupt if Serbia take the lead. Petrovic. Back outside to Petulia. Good! Three-pointer! Serbia have stormed into the lead.
And we were just saying how Serbia haven't hit a three. Look at that, 1 for 9. I don't think it could have come at a better time.
And a foul, and you go back, really, I really think that was a mistake by Mundelo to get that technical, because since that point, Serbia have just seized the momentum. Look at the bench erupt. Look at the crowd erupt.
It is so loud in here. I'm not sure if those watching back home can really feel or hear what is going on, but it is crazy.
It is deafening.
I don't know how the players can hear anything on the court.
Nichols turns, goes in. Oh, boy, that was strong to tie it. And by the way, that was their first three-pointer of the game by Petulia. Oh, someone's gotten to no woman's land there. Able to pass it back out to the arc, to the perimeter. Dabovic dribbling with 5 on the shot clock. Pulls up at the line.
I mean, really, that's not a bad move. That's Dabovic's shot.
I still like to think maybe try to get it. Oh, look at Chacho. Forces, comes up with the steal. And Petrovic with the catch down low. She turns, she goes up, and she puts Serbia back in front.
Oh, my goodness. This game is so exciting. And like you said, it kind of goes back. What was the momentum changer?
The technical foul, yes, on Mundelo for complaining when he had an 8-point lead. Cruz into indoor, gets her rebound back. Oh! And I think an unsportsmanlike is going to be called because Dabovic lashed out and hit indoor.
Let's take a look at this if you can. And I mean, look. Missed opportunity here. You had two people.
Watch this.
Oh, I think she kind of got mad because she felt indoor might have swung at her.
Well, they might want to look at it.
The entire sequence to see...
You guys would not believe this. We've got Tomasevic drawing it out with Garbajosa. They used to do it on the court. Now they're doing it here as representatives of their federation. I think Tomasevic, rather, took exception to Garbajosa standing up and asking for an unsportsmanlike.
Now
watch Dabovic. Yeah.
I think it was a retaliation. It was silly. It was stupid. It's not what you expect from Ana Dabovic. I think, you know, she's frustrated. She's having to play with a broken hand. But this might be the foul that is the tipping point and the momentum switches for Spain, just like Lucas Mondello's technical was the momentum changer for Serbia.
Well, it's definitely given 2 free throws, and Dabovic got the red mist. Just kind of lost her composure. She's fouled out of the game with the unsportsmanlike. And here she is missing
the foul.
A free throw, so
yeah,
it's
so
a
it's
potential.
Bonus, so that's why she's shooting two.
Yeah. And they will also keep possession.
So she shot two unsportsmanlike fouls, two free throws, and then they get possession.
Right.
So the first two were actually the free throws
right.
from the foul on the rebound. Second two were the unsportsmanlike, and here we have the possession. And this could, oh, I was just about to say, this could be a 5 or 6 point swing, and Anna Cruz stepped out of bounds. It's a 15th turnover by Spain.
So they called the foul first, and then they called the unsportsmanlike foul on top of that. Well, the pass to Brooks. And now the Serbia fans are appealing for an unsportsmanlike.
I mean, good thing this refereeing crew is probably one of the best.
Yeah.
Best around.
Petolia gets inside, misses, but Nichols flies in for the rebound. Now again to Brooks, and she puts it up, and it was short. For Spain. Hold on to a one-point lead. And the pass goes over the head of Nichols. Serbia have won 7 of the 10 previous games in which Jelena Brooks has scored 15 or more points at this at the Eurobasket. So that's a good sign for Serbia.
See, that's that. Spain, six turnovers and
quarter.
zero for Serbia.
Spain clinging to a one-point lead. Jovanović goes in, tries to get the contact, maybe forcing it a bit much. I'd be tempted to try to get Brooks the ball every time down the floor, a touch. Cruz from the baseline. Jovanović with the rebound. We're going to have a dramatic finish, folks. You might want to get a sedative or something.
These 6,000 people paid for to see, right? This isn't the first game in this tournament that it's been a dramatic finish for Serbia.
Brooks, has it taken away by Laura Gill. It's never fun playing against her. Coming up on a minute to go in the game, and Palau has it. Cruz, and then a foul out on the perimeter. So free throws for Spain. It looked like Spain were probably going to win this thing for about 32 minutes.
Yeah, I was going to say 32 minutes.
And now it's just up in the air.
But, you know, you saw that 6 turnovers by Spain, and Serbia really didn't take advantage. They took the lead on those three out of 4 free throws by Astu Endor, and that was a few possessions ago.
And Laudergill makes 1 of 2.
Spain shooting 9 of 15 from the free throw line, so not a great percentage for them either. Just thinking if this does go down to kind of free throw shooting at the end.
Charger has it. Okay, Petolia now. And Petrovic. He's going to go right at Nichols. She pulls up for a jumper. This is badly. She's had a rough night. And now a block called on Petrovic.
So Spain will be going to the free throw line.
I don't understand why Serbia has
gone away from Brooks.
Or just get some penetration and go to the basket and try to get to the free throw line.
Spain, like I said, 9 of 15. Silvia Dominguez is 0 for 0.
Look at the fans. They can hardly believe it. They can hardly... Oh, the noise. The noise. It is tough making free throws in this arena right now. So Dominguez does a good job of making that one. Remember, Serbia came all the way back to lead, having trailed by 10 points. And now they're back behind by 3. Well, Dominguez makes both. Probably one of the MVPs of the game, really. She and Cruz.
Second one was very big because she just made it a 2-possession game. They're down 4, so they don't need to go for a 3. They need to go for a good shot, a 2 or a 3.
It's not been a good night for 3-point shooting. And that is the free throw shooting.
Cambio, cambio en todo. Me da igual el mismo. Rebote.
So those who understand Spanish, he did say we're switching everywhere and rebounding on defense.
Making sure to rebound.
Yep.
Rebote. So, if I'm Serbia, I'm going hard to the hole.
Yep. Like I said, there's no reason to kind of shoot a fadeaway jump shot, a tough shot.
Here she goes. Drives in tough. Follows up the miss. Gets it back. Brooks for 3. Short. And the ball goes out of bounds. I think it's going to be Serbia ball. So 14
Still
seconds
lots
on the
of
shot
time.
Clock. 17.5
Those
seconds
were
remain.
Two good looks, in my opinion, by Serbia.
Really pressure. Remember, Spain foul. Serbia will go to the line. And now Malkovic decides to call another timeout. Yeah, a lot can happen with 16.7 seconds.
But, oh, yeah.
But Spain clearly prefer their position to Serbia's.
Yeah. I mean, we've seen dramatic ends in this tournament, especially involving Serbia. There you see the game leaders. Tulia, 12 points. Petrovic, 6 rebounds and 6 assists.
Si fallan, rebote.
17 points. Nicholas, 9 rebounds. Dominguez with 5 assists. To go along with 10 points for Dominguez.
I just wonder, Servan Dakic was so good.
We haven't seen her.
She came out.
Yeah.
And also Brooks was in such fine fettle, but then she became not the number one option. Here's your fan again, trying to get it inside. The ball doesn't fall kindly. They dive on the floor for the loose ball. And it's going to be Spain possession. A good attempt
and
under pressure.
We can't deny that. There you see Avinia You can't deny that Serbia had, they had good looks. They had decent looks. You had the take by Petrovic. They got the offensive rebound. It was a three-point shot by
Brooks.
Brooks, sorry.
Yeah.
She had a good look. It was just a little short. There you see fast break points. That's a big difference. 16 to just 4. But then again, Spain like to play an up-tempo, fast game. Really right here, what's important for Spain is to not turn the ball over. You have 8 seconds. Serbia has to go for a steal and then try and foul fast. But if you're Spain, the thing you don't want to do is turn the ball over, which might lead to an easy quick 2 or 3 for Serbia. You have 8 seconds left. You don't have to score. You can hold the ball, pass it around, because Serbia are going to... So you see Coach... I think Coach Lucas Mondello took this timeout, and he decided he wants to go full court. So, you know, Coach obviously has a choice to advance the ball into the front court. Mondello here is deciding to risk the full court. Sometimes it can be dangerous because you could turn it over right underneath your basket.
Yeah. I think Serbia, when they're going to look back at this, it's going to be an unfortunate sequence for them that has really worked against them, although they did have other opportunities. But the unsportsmanlike foul.
I mean, that's what sticks out in my mind.
I mean, even on the scoreboard, because they were winning when that took place, 66-64. And then Indoor got the, Dabrovic got the unsportsmanlike after fouling Indoor.
Yeah.
She picked up
a
few fouls.
Yep.
So she got the 3 of the 4 free throws, and they've led ever since. But, things happen in the heat of the moment, and you certainly, I don't think you should ever lash out and hit somebody. But
I mean, it really wasn't hard. No. It wasn't,
It could be that she was feeling some pain after being hit, though. Anyway, final seconds ticking off the clock. Petolia puts it up, and Žargaj gets the block, and Spain robs Serbia of a famous moment on their home floor in Belgrade. And just two great champions, really, battling it out, and a lot of respect for each other. Tremendous, tremendous heavyweight fight here in the Belgrade Arena. 71-66, Spain win it. And guess what? It's going to be Spain against France once again in the final. Game, you know what? It's hard to win a Eurobasket whether you're the host or not. And again, the team, the number 2 team in the FIBA world ranking for women, presented by Nike, certainly it's extremely difficult no matter where you play, no matter when you play. Not even if Alba Torrens, if she doesn't show up. This is yet another one of those famous moments for Spanish basketball, but Serbia battled.
Yeah.
And they've won their share of close games in this Eurobasket.
A lot of people didn't even have Serbia meddling at this tournament. Here we'll see, get a look at the stats. Not great three-point shooting, 50% compared to 44 from the 2 for Spain. Really, three-point shooting was not pretty tonight. Assists, steals, more or less on par.
They just couldn't quite get enough stops for
long
stretches of the game.
It was really the consecutive stops that I felt Serbia were having a hard time getting.
And then it was
the leaders.
The difficult moment.
Astu Endor with 17 points, Lauer Nichols 10 rebounds, Dominguez 5 assists, Petulia led Serbia in scoring. A block, Jovanovic with 2 steals, Žargaj with 2 blocks, Gil with 3 steals, a big one at the end on Brooks. Cruz, I thought, was excellent for them, especially in the first half. Stankovic, really good game. I think she's proven herself that, coach can rely on her and she can play big minutes for this team, especially if Brooks and maybe Petrovic are struggling a little bit. But like you said, you felt the momentum shift when Coach Lucas Mondello of Spain got that technical foul. And then unfortunately, it really shifted and Serbia had trouble scoring when Dabović picked up that rebounding foul and then sort of lashed out and got the unsportsmanlike. I think she was frustrated. I think she was hurting. She felt, you know, Astuendor kind of swung at her first. And really, that was, it wasn't the play of the game, but it's what put Spain up when they couldn't figure out how to score and they were just able to hang on with their defense and with their rebounding. But, you know, really a lot of people going into this tournament didn't have Serbia making this far. They still have a chance to play for a medal. Let's not forget, they're going to that Olympic qualification tournament, so we possibly will see them next summer in the Tokyo Olympics 2020. Spain is Spain. You know, yeah. Somehow they always just manage to get it done. And, you know, a lot of these women and the core group of women who play for the Spanish team, they've been around and they've played many, many games together. So they really know each other well. They know help is going to be there. They know each other's strengths and weaknesses, and they make up for all of that because they know each other so well. And it's fun to see. I mean, they know how to get it done.
They do, and you know, it's a model program. It's one of these model federations, and Spanish Federation puts a lot of time and energy into their program. They have a lot of pride in it, and it's the one team that's kind of non-negotiable for all these players. You know, when they get the call, they want to play. Mm-hmm. And I mean, you can't expect a player to play every single summer, but they almost always turn out. You know,
yeah.
So. And the fact that they have been able to do this this year without Alba Torrens, again, just kind of magnifies how special and how deep that program is.
Yeah.
With Spanish women's basketball. They hosted the World Cup last year. They had the disappointment of settling for third place. You know, you always dream about finishing on top of the podium when you host the event, and that's what Serbia was hoping for, and it looked like it was a real possibility. Especially when they came back and they took the lead tonight. You know, you just had that feeling. It was kind of like, oh, maybe it is going to be
yeah.
Serbia's year. But it wasn't to be. And now the challenge, as it always is to put this behind you and get ready to play tomorrow against a very good team from Great Britain. There's Jorge Garbajos and Lucas Mondello hugging each other. And, of course, sure that Jorge Garbajosa has no issues whatsoever with Mondello at the helm. This is what's happened today. Belgium and Sweden won the first two games, so they clinched top six finishes and earned spots in the FIBA Women's Olympic Qualifying Tournament. And then France saw Great Britain, and we've just seen Serbia beat Spain. So the final and the third place game will be tomorrow. Thanks for watching, everybody. For Shona Thorburn, I'm Jeff Taylor, signing off in the Belgrade Arena.